Play Girls, and welcome to another video. Well, it's a tutorial of how to transfer all your CC to your hard drive. I do actually, I already have a lot of CC that's already transferred to my hard drive, but I have a few that's not in there. But here's just a small tutorial. It's nothing big and whatnot. First off, you want to start out by actually installing the Link Shell extension. This is what you're going to use to put the files as a junction into the mods folder. So what you're going to do, you're going to just click this, scroll all the way down to download, and you will click the bit that's for you. Mostly all windows are just 64. I never seen one that's 32. I don't know, but you will click these two here for 60, here for the 64 bit, and then you will click this. And I already have it installed, but you'll just go through the process of installing it and whatnot. It will install to your computer and woo. So here is also what you want to do. You want to go to your mods folder, since now that you have installed Link Shell extension, because that's key to like making the junction. So you're gonna open a new window to your hard drive and have another window out for your mods. That goes to your mods folder. So as you can see here, I have already have most of my stuff. Junctions, these are all junction folders files, but these are of course the files itself. This is the junction. This is like a clone, basically a clone of the files. What file can I use? I could use this, because I didn't make it a file. I didn't make it a junction because it's not that much CC. So let me see. What? Oh wait. Oh wait. Nope. Not touch that. Cause yeah. What else? What I got that's I can put. Mostly I have, as you can see, pregnancy overhaul. These are mods. Most of mods I only have like probably like three or four. Regular CC folders that are not like on my hard drive, because it's not a big file. They don't have many CC. Probably only have like Riot Studios. This only has like 3 CC, so it's like no point in me putting it on a hard drive. Even though my hard drive has hella lot of space, I could put a lot of stuff, and it's just like still, there's no point of putting that there. But I think we're gonna use that as an example. Whatnot. I don't have. Okay, whatever. You know what? Actually, I would say I would use that. You're gonna use your Dork Fans. We're gonna use this one. So what you're gonna do is, some people say copy. You can just copy and paste it, but I think you could also just move it to it. Move it to your hard drive, but you're just gonna go with the old-fashioned way. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna copy and paste it to your hard drive, that folder, specific folder to your hard drive, and you're going to right click, show more options, and you're gonna click pick link source. Once you pick link source, you're gonna go to Sense4, you're gonna click a right click on mods, you're gonna show more options, and you're going to drop as junction, and you're gonna go back into your mods folder, and you can see the junctions from here, and you could just delete this like, and then empty cycle, boom, and it will now be in here, and you will notice that the space is gone. You also like restart your computer. I can't restart it because I'm recording, but if you restart your computer, but if you like restart your computer, you will notice the amount of space. My, before I even had, when I didn't have my hard drive, it was here. Yeah, it was right there. And now that I have most of my stuff, and I also moved my Sims 4 game, as you can see here. Hold on, where is it at? Right here, I moved my Sims to my hard drive now. As you can see, I guess you can see here. It's also released a lot of space. So yeah, that did a good toll for me, thank God. But other than that, you could just keep doing that. Don't do it with these files. Don't just do it with regular files. Do it with the folder. You have to do it with the folders. But also a high suggestion, just leave all the mods. Like, I got, these are mods I have. As you can see, traits, I only have this. I don't bother because it's only two files. It's not that really that big of a deal for me to put it on the hard drive. I got Rooms and Cabo. These are mods. I try to keep a lot of mods in folders so that way I don't lose them. But you can see I have other files that I can easily look for in out. I can have it out right here. So that's just that. But yeah, most of these mods, most of these CCs are technically in my hard drive. But I have my mods in my regular folder. I don't have it as a junction. So I highly suggest, if you got any mods, have a lot of mods, because you can put Extreme Violence in a folder. I even got Insomnia mods in here. Oh Lord Jesus, I just stuttered. But wait a minute. Oh, I'm tripping. I was thinking about something else, but yeah, I have all their mods in here. So I keep them in there. I don't bother making a junction, so that way I could just switch it out. But also, I guess you're probably gonna be some good question in the comment section, so I might go ahead and answer it right here, right now. That you can add CC to it. Only this one. Don't add the CC. Don't click on the junction files and add your CC. Like, if you're adding something for Brandy Sims, you will go to Brandy Sims folder. If you do that, you sort your CC through creators, which I highly suggest you do. Like here, I have all creators. It's nothing but creators and mods. I have the name of the mod, specific mod I use. I have it by the creator or the name of the mod. So like, let's say you're trying to put in Brandy Sims CC. You will go on your hard drive and hit on the folder, and you'll drop all your CC in there. Don't do it through the junction. I don't know what it does, but it's just a smart move. I don't know exactly what it does. It could possibly mess things up. I don't know for sure. Because junctions, these are just clones. These are like kind of like empty clones or something like that. Or however you want to put it. It substitutes for the actual file. So it takes out, it releases all that storage, as you can see here. Because I was literally right here before I had my hard drive. When I got my hard drive, it dropped here. I'm trying to drop it even more, but it's because I got other apps on my computer, so it's not because of Sims and my CC, because everything's on here. But yeah, mostly if you want to put CC in, you can't put CC in. You just got to do it through the hard drive and put in the file, not the mod folder. And probably somebody's gonna ask, like, can you do the mod folder? I tried that before when I was first learning the hard drive. Don't do it. Just do it like this. Nothing else like this. I don't know if there's any other tips I got for y'all. I really don't. But other than that, yeah, this is going to be technically the end of the tutorial. I already told y'all a little thing. Like, name your stuff. Like, you got the retail mod. Simpsons combo. I got Realistic Birth. I don't know if she updated this stuff. I still got it in my game. I don't care. But OnlyFans mod. We're not going to talk about it. But yeah. I got all these other type of mods in my game. I got all these type of mods. I have them in folders named by the specific mods. I don't forget. And I have like all the CC creators. They all go by CC creators. That's it. Nothing but straight CC creators. So yeah, that's all of I got for you guys as a tutorial. Hope this really helps for everybody who has a hard drive or just now getting a hard drive and trying to transfer all their CC to their hard drive. That's how you do it. It's really easy. But the next tutorial will be on how to install G-Shade and presets into your game. Hope you have a good night or day, depending on what time you are and when time this video comes out. Have a good one.